Hey guys, I'm Wench Fairy, and welcome to Dragon Age Inquisition! We are up here in the little tower thing in Skyhold. Solas is way down there. Because it occurred to me we should probably listen to whatever Dagna managed to capture on this memory crystal with Liliana. Before I ran up here, I re-outfitted everybody with the new stuff we picked up last time. I also changed 6 of the pots in the garden from elf fruit to prophet's laurel, so I can upgrade some of the potions. And so let's talk to Liliana here.
Have we smuggled the other memory crystal into Calpurnia's camp?
We have. Here.
Oh, so we're listening live.
Even honey can't sweeten Philandris. I'll keep trying. You are no slave, Linnea. I'll add another spoonful myself later.
She definitely remembers being a slave.
Calpurnia seems to be treating her new acolytes kindly.
While I found that interesting, this is what you must hear.
Looks like she punches it.
Forgive me, I didn't expect.
The time for your ascension is. Tell me of your preparation.
Their lips look really strange.
They go well enough, although I'm distracted here. If I could train at the shrine.
Only Dumont's faithful may enter. Continue as before. Or would you see the Imperium's rebirth stalled by your lack of focus?
I will be ready, as the vessel, and Tevinter's champion.
More vesselness.
How much training does becoming the vessel involve?
Another deflection. Why, a dwarven bauble, as if mine was miraculously returned to me.
Yeah-oh.
Let's give your new owner a glimpse of her fate. Venatori, we leave.
That is all the crystal recorded before she found it. But I think it may be enough. A shrine to Dumat, Corypheus said. Where Calpurnia is forbidden to go.
We kind of know who Dumat is, but I'm sure Liliana can give us better information.
Who is this Dumat that Corypheus mentioned?
An old god, worshipped in ancient Tevinter as the Dragon of Silence. He was the first to
rise. I was just gonna say, he was the first archdemon.
Bring the blight. Truly a god fit for Corypheus.
He's not telling her something.
I bet Corypheus has something in that shrine he doesn't want Calpurnia to see.
Yep.
I agree. There is much to gain here. Whatever Corypheus hides from his trusted lieutenant should be eluded.
She said lieutenant!
Let us investigate this shrine. Carefully. I doubt Corypheus has left it unguarded.
Probably not. Alright. Investigate the Shrine of Dumat, operation available. We are, however, not going to do that right this second. We're going to get stuck in between these things, really? If you'll excuse me a moment of indulgence, I want to read this note again. Shmoobles the second. Okay. As you might know, I am playing the Dragon Age Origins playthrough that is the beginning of Hera's quote-unquote canon. I'm currently playing it. And last night, we gave Liliana Shmoobles the first. So I just wanted to see how many Shmoobles there had been. Alright, first thing we're going to do is jump over this balcony. Oh, hi. Then we're going to go this way. We're going to go check in with the advisors. Send them to do things. So I think it's finally time for us to go to Halam Sheral. Oh, there's a lady here. That means they're going to say something. No?
Master Solas asked that, did he? He said it was at your convenience, my lady.
No, I'll see to it right away. His hunches are usually correct.
Cool. Good to know that about Solas. So let's check in with everybody at the war table. Oh man, my load screens are so much faster since I took out that Skyhold pajama mod. Like, you don't even know. That's so good. Okay. We have someone to check in over here. Oh, this was an offer of help on their terms. It was a dwarf from Cal Shirok. Our soldiers report that they passed through the tunnel without incident and surprised a sizable Venatori encampment. After the battle, they had to find a different route back because the tunnel had been collapsed. They found this letter. A letter on Dark Velen with obviously dwarven markings. You follow instructions well. Respect for territory is a first step. We shall see. Oh, nice. And they gave us a bit for Bianca. I want to do this, but let's check in with everyone else first. Back to the Ferelden Free Marches side of the map. Power for a price. The Inquisition is a sight to behold, a command of legions, hearts, and mind. It is worthy, your Inquisitor is worthy, and my master should please. I will bring my wares, and together we will extend your reach ever further. Now you trade not just treasures, but in will. Okay, thank you, I guess. We had to choose to help the soldiers or help the wounded people, and we helped the wounded people. Your help arrived just in time. My sisters and I have seen the soldiers safely to Ferelden. I cannot express what this means to all of us. Maker's blessings upon you and our rescuers. Commander, we've lost of our Templar's trails, awaiting further orders. Yeah, we knew that was going to happen. That's kind of...
I should inspect the condition of the trebuchets. They must be calibrated to reach the proper range.
You and your trebuchets.
Again? How many times will you be doing that?
Okay. What's this rescue the port on the Storm Coast? Oh, restore, not rescue. Turn us your own use, may be able to assist Ivor of the Blades. We can hardly expect a bustling trade center, but since we've established a presence in both Ferelden and Orlais, direct access to the Waking Sea could prove useful. Oh, yeah? Let's do that. Okay, well, I want to use Cullen for this, but I would really like to do that Red Jenny one. Let's go take a look. I'll never understand how they function with the same name. Sometimes we trade off baddies, some nod learns your tricks, message another Red Jenny, now you're twice as hard to catch. Looks like magic except no demons, and no magic I suppose. Anyway, the caravan we took over, there's two leads on that one from two other Jennies. Good ones too. Simple sketches of the other Red Jennies and their locations are scribbled below, their mustaches seem improbable. So we have to decide which one we want to go after. I'd really rather not leverage Cassandra's last name. Okay, we're gonna do this one. I want Liliana for it.
I want Liliana
for half the things on the map, but that one's fine. This one is a Dorian one. He wants to discover Corypheus's real name or first name or original name to try and discredit him. The Grand Archivist. Okay. Bribe the man with gifts and favors as a normal full Tervinter and what he expects. Oh, we're not going to threaten him. Okay, I think we want to use Josephine for that. Let's go back to the one I wanted to use Cullen for. You know, is the port really a priority for me, though? Let's read this one. This is the follow-up to the diverting soldiers through the Frostbacks. Inquisitor Adar. You may not remember me. I stayed at Skyhold for a time and later accompanied some major soldiers to Ferelden. If I may help the Inquisition in some small way, you may only have to ask. Oh, let her remain with her fellow sisters in peace. Makes sense. Oh, well, that's... No, I like Cullen for that. Would I rather use her to help me first or build that port? I don't know. There's so many things we've not even looked at. Found my resources. We just unlocked this by finding all of the stanzas of her saga. Which oral tradition of the Avar has been largely lost. They think... So this guy thinks we can find... Or this girl, sorry, Sister Dorcas. Thinks we can find Tirda's legendary axe. A crystal-headed axe said to burn with flame. I thought I recognized the last name. You know what? I was gonna put Cullen on that one. Let's take one quick look over the things we haven't looked at in Orlais. That's the one we just got. I don't care about that. Resources. We're not unlocking these places yet. Oh, maybe we should at least look at this Protect Valgamord from Darkspawn. I'm not sending the Grey Wardens there. Mm. I want to use Liliana for this one. It is odd to see a town threatened by Darkspawn. Still not doing that one. Oh, hey. We have Josephine we can use, don't we? No, we did not want to use Josephine for that. I should really make a list. Okay, back over here. We're gonna Oh, we have Cullen or Josephine for this too. Oh no, we don't. We only have Josephine. You know what?
Inquisitor.
The Kirkwall Guard can deal with this guy. We have bigger things to worry about. So, do we want to send Sister Paulette to Crestwood first, or do we want to locate this weapon? You know what? This one takes a bajillion hours, right? Yes. Let's do this one first.
To work?
And now we're going to head to Halamshahral. The Empress's ball is fast approaching, and it wouldn't do us to be late. Plus we are over-leveled for it. Well, I guess that's so over-leveled. It's only one level.
Is Knight Captain Ryland satisfied with his post?
It's not an easy assignment, but if anyone can handle the approach, it's him.
So, an assassin is stalking the Empress. Selene's death would plunge Orlais into chaos, leaving it an easy target for Corypheus. At the Winter Palace of Halamshahral, Selene is holding peace talks with her rebellious cousin Grand Duke Gaspard under the guise of a grand ball. Every noble in the Empire will attend, making it the perfect place and time for Corypheus' assassin to strike. We can arrange an invitation to attend to keep him from destroying Orlais, if we hurry. Well, I've been putting it off for long enough. It's time to go.
We have to reach the Empress before Corypheus. The only question is, how?
We're getting all fancy for the
we
ball.
We know how. I have our way in. The real question is, where is our enemy hiding?
Liliana?
At the urging of Grand
Maybe?
Duchess Florian, the Empress is holding a ball.
Feels like
Absolutely
her area of expertise.
Everyone will be there. During the festivities, Celine will be meeting for peace talks with the usurper Duke Gaspard and Ambassador Briala. The assassin must be hiding within one of these factions.
So, just to address the obvious, Hera let her hair down a little. It clips kind of bad with her outfit, but I'm hoping it won't be so bad once we get to the ball. I just thought it would be nice to have a fancy hairdo at Halamshahral. So, tell me about Empress Selene.
Tell me everything we know about the Empress.
Empress Selene is a renowned diplomat and reformer. She works tirelessly to secure peace for the Empire. Unfortunately, many Orlesians view peace as complacency. She has yet to name an heir, leaving the future of the Empire in doubt if anything happens to her. Especially when the next in line is her cousin Gaspard, who's made few friends on the Council of Heralds. Selene is surrounded at all times by countless guards, courtiers, servants, and vassals. What better place for an assassin to hide than the Empress's own household?
So the guy she's in the civil war with is her heir.
How can Gaspard still be next in line while he wages war against his Empress?
The title Grand Duke indicates that he was a prince.
How does Cullen know this?
Throne.
Oh, okay. Tell me about him.
What do we know about Duke Gaspard?
The man who would have been emperor. He's Selene's cousin and was first in line to inherit the throne when Emperor Florian died. Selene outmaneuvered him. She won over the Council of Heralds, who hold authority over title disputes. She became Empress, and he a general in the Imperial Army. He's well-loved by the troops.
Oh, I guess that's why he knows
it. He's also a
chevalier. He's an army guy.
Most of their number sided with him when he turned on the Empress.
So he's got the chevaliers.
Aren't the chevaliers part of the army? Why would they follow the Duke?
Most chevaliers are sworn to serve the crown, but that does not give them faith in the person wearing it. The Empress has tried to improve relations with Ferelden and Navarra. The chevaliers see her as anti-military. They believe Gaspard could lead the Empire back to the glory of Draken's expansion years.
Oh, great! That sounds fabulous. Tell me about this Ambassador Briala. I don't think I've ever heard of her before.
Who is this Ambassador Briala?
An ambassador in name only, she has organized the elves of Halam Sheral into an underground army. The Empress invited her to the peace talks in a bid to gain the elves' alliance in the war.
That's kind of smart of her.
That would be scandal enough, without the rumor that Briella is a jilted lover of Celine's.
Oh.
A personal grudge and a network of saboteurs at her command. Promising lead.
She... to the point where everybody knows had an elven lover?
Wait. The elven leader is a jilted lover of the Empress?
It's not widely known.
Oh.
Just a rumor whispered among the palace servants a few years ago. If it's true and where to get out, the Empress and an elf. This scandal could destroy Celine's court.
Huh.
Even if a lie, Briella could use it to blackmail the Empress. She has some connection to the throne.
So why are we getting ourselves involved in all this anyway?
Do we need to go to the peace talks? The Empress must have personal guards. We could just warn her she's in danger.
We've made the attempt, but...
it seems that our messages never reached her. Someone intercepted them.
Oh.
It's better that we don't leave this to chance. If Orlais falls to Corypheus, no land is safe.
All right. I got my hair all done. Let's go.
We shouldn't waste any time. Let's go to the Winter Palace.
So, power costs 30. I think we can afford it. The real question is, who are we taking with us to Orlais? This has to happen. But who else? I feel like Vivienne's a smart choice. Yeah, Vivienne will be our mage. Cassandra, Blackwall, or Bull? Let's take Bull. This party can be nothing if not hilarious.
The political situation in Halam Sheral hangs by a thread. The Empress fears our presence could sever it.
Well, we're not trying to make things bad.
The Grand Duke is only too happy to have us at the ball as his guests, so our invitation comes from him.
I guess that's fair.
Whether we
he
act
seems
as
like
allies
the shit disturber.
Or upset the balance of power, he gains an opportunity, if not a clear advantage.
Here we come.
Inquisitor Adar, it is my great pleasure to meet you. The rumors coming out of the Western Approach say you battled an army of demons.
That would be true.
Imagine what the Inquisition could accomplish with the full support of the rightful Emperor of Orlais.
And which Emperor is
and
that,
which one
please?
Was the rightful one again? I keep getting them confused.
The handsome, charming one, of course, my lady.
Ah.
I am not a man who forgets his friends, Inquisitor. You help me, I'll help you. My lady, are you prepared to shock the court by walking into the Grand Ball with a hateful usurper?
Pretty much, yeah.
They will be telling stories of this into the next age.
Aren't we exciting people?
I can't imagine that crowd has seen anything better than us in their entire lives.
You're yeah. a woman after my own heart, my lady. As a friend, perhaps there is a matter you could undertake this evening.
Uh-oh. Now we ask for the favors.
I suspect that she intends to disrupt the negotiations. My people have found these ambassadors all over the fortifications. Sabotage seems the least of their crimes.
All right. Well, I'll look into it for you.
Sounds like something I should look into.
Be as discreet as possible.
Have you met me?
I detest.
Do I look discreet to you?
But if we do not play it well, our enemies will make us look like villains. We're keeping the court waiting, Inquisitor. Shall we?
Is that the Inquisitor?
Yep.
An ox. Possible.
Actually, I'm a Qunari.
Inquisitor, it's just somebody's pet.
I will have to work extremely hard. Oh my God, who went for? Oh no. Okay. Fabulous. So that means we're doing all the side quests. Okay, little note. Yes, I have modded Hera's hair to be long and her outfits to be black and red as opposed to red and blue. This is not a result of the patch that added the outfit choices in the wardrobe. This is a mod that I just installed. Literally, I went, did the war table stuff, exited the game, loaded two more new mods, and came back into the game. So this is all, obviously the links will be in the description below. The hair clips kind of bad with her because it's just like a stretched mesh. There's no like physics to it. We're just going to have to deal with it. Let's talk to this noblewoman right here. Hi.
Oh, wait there. Whatever your name is, have you seen a ring? It is very important.
You don't have to talk slow. I speak English.
A gift from the Countess Montbelliard, enchanted by the Fomari. I cannot go into the ball without it.
What is this?
What's your game?
Yeah.
Are you trying to convince the Comtesse that you treasure her gift? Or just gain importance by getting the Inquisitor to run a menial errand for you?
Oh, we gained court approval.
I assure you, the ring truly is lost. And I must find it or risk terrible repercussions.
I'll find your stupid ring for you.
Should you happen upon it, I beg you, let me know.
Something tells me it's over this way. Clipping hair is clipping. Whatever, it's fine. Return it to the noblewoman or keep it to sell later. Is it worth a lot? It doesn't even get flavor text. No. I'll just give it back to this stupid lady.
Maker, what am I going to do if I cannot find my ring?
Oh, here's your stupid ring.
Is this the ring you are looking for?
You are a treasure. I cannot believe you found it. You have saved me a lifetime of mortification. How can I thank you enough?
You're fine. I just need to worry about these numbers. So, I have played this before. I am not using a guide. This is, okay, this preface this. This is mostly for people who have played Wicked Eyes, Wicked Hearts. I have played this before. I'm not using a guide to get all of the collectible things that are in here. Nor am I going to metagame to figure out who's going to be in charge of Orlais. However, I have played this before, so I know how some of this plays out. So they'll be metagaming to the point where I know what's going to happen and I don't want to do it.
We can only hope Celine prevails tonight. Gaspar will ruin us all.
Running is probably a bad plan.
Can Gaspar take the throne without the backing of the Council of Heralds?
He plans to take it by force. If the Council will recognize him, he'll march against them.
I figure we should listen in on as many conversations as possible here, because we don't really understand Orlesian politics. What does this plaque say? The Verschel Fountain. Emperor Judicale I commissioned this massive fountain to commemorate the House of Valmont's historic victory against Xavier Drakon. Celine is a Valmont, I know that much. The four lions represent Emperor Alphonse Valmont and Isidore Darlesians, Yvonne Severin, and... Huh, okay. I know Celine is a Valmont.
Oh. Are all the Delancey's here?
Maker, I hope not.
Okay, apparently the Delancey's are a sketchy family, I guess by Orlesian standards. Oh, well, we don't have the key to that door.
Lady Nightingale makes me nervous.
She should make you nervous. She makes me nervous and she works for me. With me. She doesn't work for me.
It's been too long since I've had any word from Valois.
Okay. Requires more Hala statuettes. Okay. What's up on this side? Oh. I assume. Yep, there's a Hala. We have one of those on the fireplace in our house. It's our house. Our room at Skyhold.
Delancey is here.
Maker, I hope not. Okay. Anything down here? Yeah. Oh, there's some stuff. What? Did I take actual damage from that? I hope not. Approach the talking nobles? Which ones? These ones?
This is a private conversation. Please leave.
Okay. Find a safe spot to eavesdrop. I guess over here? Yes, somewhere over here.
Interesting.
Let's eavesdrop. Why not?
Any word from the front lines?
My spies said the bodies were beyond counting.
Surely the Empress will put an end to the war tonight.
Pray, my friend. If the Maker does not hear us now, just pray.
Okay. What is actually up here, though? Oh, the key to the storage room is below us. Fabulous. Shortcut. What's in here? So yeah, here's sparkling. Take secret trade documents. Oh. Find scandalous secrets for Liliana, eh? That sounds like a good time, actually. Elysian Army Battle Mage Armor. Oh, can I? Armor. See, I can't wear the mask because I'm not a human. Nor do we have anyone with us to trade into it.
We can only hope Celine prevails tonight. Is it true?
Well,
the visitor was headed out of the Fae by Andresti?
Well, I won't answer that question. How's that sound? So one hollow statue goes here. And this. Staff of Flares. And some heavy Orlesian Army armor. You know, while we're hidden here, inventory is what I want. Oh, I don't have anyone else. Never mind. I was going to try on those two armors we just found on Vivienne and Bull, but they're not with us yet. I was trying to walk that way, guys. Okay, well, I guess we'll enter the Winter Palace.
Inquisitor, a moment, if you please.
Josephine, you look
lovely. I must warn you before you go inside. How you speak to the court is a matter of life and death. It is no simple matter of etiquette and protocol. Every word, every gesture is measured and evaluated for weakness.
Oh, don't they sound like a fun bunch?
Don't they sound delightful? I'm shocked we haven't invited the court to dinner at Skyhold.
The game is like Wicked Grace played to the death. You must never reveal your cards.
Okay.
When you meet the Empress, the eyes of the entire court will be upon you. You are safer in the Fade with the Fear Demon.
Oh, great!
You are just full of joy and light this evening.
Everything will be fine. Andraste, watch over us all.
She doesn't have a whole lot of faith in me. So here we are. Oh, we're not allowed out. What's over here? Is this door roped off? No, but it's also not really a door. What about over here? These doors are roped off, so something tells me we'll be able to get down there at some point. I'll have to remember that.
Is that the Inquisitor?
Yep.
Econoli? Surely not.
Actually, I am. Hi, Colin. You look lovely.
It'll take some time to get our men into the palace. I'll alert you when we're ready.
Huh. Oh.
How can they call this a vestibule? It's a foyer.
Please, it's barely half the size of the foyer in the Imperial Palace. It's obviously just a vestibule.
I'd call it more of an antechamber myself.
No one asked you.
Let's talk to this guy.
I heard Celine was having the entire wing redecorated. But the timing is atrocious.
Why would she do such a thing now?
How could the Empress afford to renovate the palace without war going on?
I heard that it wasn't renovations at all. The palace was damaged by Gaspar's catapults.
On the Winter Palace. That's monstrous. Well, it makes sense if she's here. Like... Dwarves? Hi, dwarves!
Who does Orzammar favor in the negotiations tonight?
I'm not listening.
King Iduka has put considerable coin behind the Empress in hopes the trade in foodstuffs will resume quickly.
That means I backed Balin. I don't remember doing that. Can we go this way? No. Oh, that's the one that's all locked off because they're redecorating.
How has delirium trade dropped off so sharply?
With so much fighting, demand should be higher than ever.
I have the...
My contact said there's a new supplier, but we can't track down who it might be.
Oh, I have them. Sorry. Ooh, a plaque. The Grand Library of Halam Shiral. Only the Library of the University of Orlais and the Imperial Palace Library compare. Oh, no, can't go in that one either. Theoretically... Mm. Oh, what home? Oh, I did take a shit ton of damage. Did you see that?
Boring.
Okay, apparently we didn't hear anything.
The Grand Duke invited the Inquisition here.
Yep. I don't understand why everyone else gets to look all fancy and I have to wear this outfit. Mm. Would it have been terrible to put me in a dress?
No idea.
Oh. More things we can tell Liliana.
The guest wing is not open to the public at this time, Inquisitor.
Oh, sorry. So there's Cullen. Where's everyone else that came with us? Nowhere? Okay. All right, Gaspard. This is gonna be awkward as shit. Oh, are we about to be formally introduced? Oh, maybe I shouldn't have brought Sarah and Bull with me.
And now presenting Grand Duke Gaspard de Chalon and accompanying him, Lady Inquisitor Adar.
Yeah, that's me. So that's Empress Celine. I like her dress
Shepherd
a lot.
Shepherd and Leash of the Wayward Order of Templars. Purger of the heretics from
Shepherd
the ranks of the
Leash?
Faithful.
Shepherd and Leash? Oh, that's terrible sounding.
Love it. That's not how it went.
Sarah?
Champion of the Blessed Andraste herself.
Sure, why not?
Did you see their faces? Priceless.
Where's Gaspard? Oh, he's
down there.
Accompanying
the Inquisitor, Madame Vivienne, first enchanter of the Circle of Magi. Enchanter of the Imperial Court.
This is why I brought Vivienne.
Of the Duke of
Give
Kislev,
us some cachet.
The Iron Bull, leader of the famed mercenary company Bull's Chargers. As the name might imply. Her ladyship, my bulls each, of course. Sir Cullen Stanton Rutherford of Homley.
Oh, your middle name is Stanton?
Commander of the forces of the Inquisition.
Oh, that's kind of nice.
Former Knight Commander of Kirkwall. Lady Liliana, Nightingale of the Imperial Court, Veteran of the Fifth Blight, Seneschal of the Inquisition, and Left Hand of the Divine. And Lady Josephine Charette Montillier of Antiva City.
And your middle name is Charette.
Ambassador of
the pretty.
Inquisition.
I should get going down there. Look, see Josephine, I look a little awkward, but I can walk nice like everyone else. See? Look at me go. See, I'm doing it, Josie. I'm doing it. Let me get out of your way. Go join Gaspard. I'm here.
Cousin, my dear sister.
Grand Duke,
this must be Florian.
We are always honored when your presence graces our court.
Don't waste my time with pleasantries, Celine. We have business to conclude.
We will meet for the negotiations after we have seen to our other guests.
Inquisitor.
Thank you, Gaspard.
Lady Inquisitor, we welcome you to the Winter Palace.
Well, thank you.
Allow us to present our cousin, the Grand Duchess of Leeds, without whom this gathering would never have been possible.
I like her dress.
What an unexpected pleasure. I was not aware the Inquisition would be part of our festivities.
I don't like the bows.
We
That's kind of weird.
We'll speak later, Inquisitor.
Your arrival at court is like a cool wind on a summer's day.
Okay. Josephine said that it's like wicked grace, but, and we can never, ever show our cards. So, well, we're not going to say the assassin's here. It's an honor, or... No, that's too straightforward. She didn't say this was a good thing, so we'll do this.
Let's hope the breeze does not herald an oncoming storm.
Uh-huh, I'm Harold.
Even the wisest mistake fair winds for foul. We are at the mercy of the skies, Inquisitor. How do you find Halam Shiral?
She likes it when we don't come straight out, so...
I have no words to suffice. Halam Shiral has many beauties, and I couldn't do them justice.
Your modesty does you credit.
Yay!
And speaks well for the Inquisition.
I love that little hand wiggle
Feel
she does.
Feel free to enjoy the pleasures of the ballroom, Inquisitor. We look forward to watching you dance.
Oh, I'm gonna have to dance. That wasn't a, I'm gonna have to dance. That was a darn straight, I'm gonna have to dance. Okay, what's up, Liliana?
Tell me, Yvette.
Wrong buttons.
I can... Same as always. Meaning she's after you to do more work.
Nobody should...
You always take her side.
I don't take her side.
If I have to clean up...
Who is this, Josephine?
Oh, Josephine! Is this her?
Ooh, I'm very tall.
Inquisitor, please allow me to present to you my younger sister.
Hey! It's a pleasure!
Delighted to meet you, Lady Montelier.
Inquisitor, I've heard so much about you, but not as much as I want. Josephine writes, but she never tells me anything.
What do you want to know?
True, you found the Red Templars sacrificing heretics and drinking blood from mages' veins.
No.
Yvette,
that's not true at all.
Everyone in the Kiva City is saying so. Is it true?
Yeah, it's...
There was dark magic there, yes. But none of it so... visceral.
Oh, did you check everywhere?
Yes, I checked everywhere, I promise. Jeez. What kind of goods can you give me about
this
Josephine?
This may be my only chance to hear about when Josephine was a girl.
Oh, yes. As she told you about when she was 10 and...
Yvette, stop.
Fine. What about when we were climbing the cliffs by the...
No.
She once told the Duke of...
Absolutely not.
She's no fun.
She still plays with her doll collection when no one's looking.
Yvette, that's absurd. Absolutely preposterous.
Whatever, you like dolls, I don't care. Tell me about you, Yvette.
Tell me about yourself, Lady Yvette. This is the first time I've encountered any of Josephine's family.
She would forget to mention the artists. I've been studying painting under Antiva's royal tutors. You should be proud, Josie. I'm going to be exhibiting my work next season in the city's biggest salon.
Have you actually sat down and finished the painting yet?
I must wait for my inspiration.
I must wait for your tutor's bids.
See how this family dynamic works. Josephine's family are artists and she's the hard-working... are you having a good time?
Enjoying the ball?
I see many.
The dancing is so dull, Your Worship, but the Empress's gallery is magnificent.
Yvette.
Sorry, Josie.
Go on, Josephine.
Half our royal must be empty. So many of the Empire's finest are in attendance.
They've noticed the Empress paying you special attention, but they don't quite...
I'm the Inquisitor. Of course they're paying me special attention.
This uncertainty won't last long.
They don't know how to deal with me. I'm not gonna ask Yvette who she support, because... I don't value her opinion. Can I go out here? Nope.
It's true. The Templars have returned to the faith.
No, they haven't.
We can hope this is a sign of things.
They're working for me. Sarah, what do you think?
I had hoped to tour the Royal Wing Gardens again.
I have heard they are the finest in the Empire. It's such a pity the wing is sealed.
Sarah!
Rotra beats his squire. He's a she.
As a bastard. Extra toes. What a fun, close marrying crowd.
You know tons about this, huh? How are you...
Making any new friends?
Not likely. I'm watching them watch you. They're all glances and titters. Not sure if they're allowed to like you yet. Pathetic.
So... Empress is looking forward to watching me dance. Do you want to dance with
me?
I think
I can get you to dance with me later.
Me on their precious tiles. That's a good one.
Aw, Sarah, come on.
That's not me, yeah? Couldn't be me.
Aw. Any of the Red Jennies have anything to say?
Friends of your little network.
You mean, do any of the servants ferrying tarts between these windy tits hate them enough to give up a stash or two?
Yeah, that's exactly what
yes,
I mean.
But wait, yes I am. There's some good stuff hidden around. Keep an eye out.
I will. What do you think about
any
these people?
Any thoughts on who we're investigating?
The Empress is pretty. It'd be fun to drink and kill stuff with Gaspard. Briala is friggin' funny. Elves. But it's really a pissing match with an old lover. Don't know the rest, but that explains a lot. They're all lying, but Celine's nice to look at. Good thing we're here to save her neck.
That's true, we are here to save her
neck.
Soon.
Not going anywhere.
Alright, oh, there are three hidden Red Jenny stashes. This is not one of them. In the Pendium of our Legion Theater. Yawn. Plaques to read. The Valmont Emperor, Celine's family members. Vivienne!
And here we are.
Yes.
You haven't embarrassed yourself as much as I feared. Well done, my dear.
Thanks. Do you have any advice?
Any words of wisdom for navigating the ballroom?
Speak to the Council of Heralds. Six of them are here tonight. The seventh member of the Council is indisposed. His absence will complicate the negotiations. The Council are the highest ranking players of the game. They see everything. They might know something we can use.
Okay. Have you seen anything?
Anything happening I should know?
Strange that I haven't seen much of Grand Duchess Florian. One could always find her clinging desperately to the Empress's skirts before.
Huh. Tell me about the masks.
I've always wondered, what's the Orlesian fascination with masks?
We all wear masks, my dear, not just the people in Orlais. Who you are as a daughter, a lover, a friend, are very different people from the Inquisitor and Herald of Andraste.
That's true.
Orlesians codify this truth, make it visible. By giving each of these selves its own separate
place,
they believe they can be their truest selves, unmasked.
You know, that kind of makes sense.
It seems like you enjoy this, Vivian.
This is the game, Inquisitor. Of course I enjoy it. If I didn't, I'd be dead by now.
Just out of curiosity.
Tell me, Vivian.
I assume Celine, but...
What I want is irrelevant, darling. Orlais requires stability. And that is best served.
I'm inclined to agree with you.
Be ready to act when I give the signal.
Always, my dear.
I'm glad I brought her with us.
Laurent was the love of my life. You remember my husband? Poor darling. Killed in the war.
I always feel rude for interrupting them.
Perhaps we can speak later, Inquisitor.
Okay. Oh, where
can
am I?
Get you a drink, Commander Cullen.
No, thank you.
Look at the little... Cullen's got a little crowd happening
Inquisitor,
here.
Did you need something? The sooner we track down this infiltrator, the better.
What? You look at all these people!
Attracted a following. Who are all these people?
Why are you so short?
They won't leave me alone.
Not having a good time here?
I take it you're not enjoying yourself.
At this point, the headache I'm developing is preferable to the company.
Ooh. Do you have any advice?
Do you have any advice?
Not that you...
Legion social groups don't fall within my area of expertise.
That's why I brought Vivienne.
There are a few here we can trust. Be careful.
And do you have anything to report?
Have you noticed anything out of the ordinary?
I'll let you know at once if I do.
All right.
We'll talk later.
I await your signal.
Sounds good.
What were they doing in the Western Approach? It's a wasteland.
I was fighting demons. I don't know what you think you were doing. Oh. Can I? Nope. They're very engrossed in their negotiations. Well, this must be Briala. I like her little hairnet thingy. Anything happening out here? Bunch of bottles of wine on the ground.
Have you heard from your nephew?
Not since his regiment joined the fighting.
It may not have been wise to attend to this particular engagement. I don't like that. I didn't want to come. Nobody should have. Mother made him. At least Haram Sharal has such pretty gardens.
They're
so darling. I took out my parchment.
Not another book of poetry.
Okay, I guess we should go talk to Liliana because there doesn't seem to be anything else happening here.
Temple of Sacred Ashes. Yes.
That's me. Where's Iron Bull? All right, I guess Liliana's in the vestibule. Personally, I would call it a foyer, but
I was hoping it would catch you.
Well, you told me to come talk
what
to you.
What did Duke say?
He points the finger at Ambassador Briala.
The ambassador is up to something, but she can't be our focus. The best place to strike at Celine is from her side. Empress Celine is fascinated by mysticism, foreseeing the future, speaking with the dead, that sort of rubbish. She has an occult advisor, an apostate who charmed the Empress and key members of the court as if by magic.
Uh-oh.
I've had dealings with her in the past. She is ruthless and capable of anything.
There's an apostate here.
How can Celine openly keep an apostate in the Imperial Court?
The Imperial Court has always had an official position for a mage.
Yeah, it was Vivienne.
Before now, it was little better than court jester. Vivienne was the first to turn that appointment into a source of real political power. When the circles rebelled, technically every mage became an apostate. The word lost much of its strength.
So magical mind control. We think she's bewitched
them. The minds of the court? Powerful blood magic.
She's worth investigating. Can't be sure of anything here. Both leads point toward the guest wing. It's a promising place to start. I'll coordinate with our spies to see if I can find anything better. I will be in the ballroom if you need me.
Sounds good. Can always trust Liliana bringing the intel. Oh, guest wing. Oh, it's open now. Still want to find Iron Bull. Not around here. Let's try eavesdropping again. See if we can find anything interesting. No? No? Yes. Just had to find the right spot to click.
Good to know.
Oh, excellent. Oh, good. We didn't actually lose those scandalous secrets. Let's bring them to Liliana while we have the chance. Wait. Okay, those are in the next room. I saw those. Okay. Let's go this way first. Elves.
Friends, get these pastries out to the diplomats.
The Duchess has asked for too many. I can't carry them all.
I heard the Inquisition was here.
You're too gullible.
Dudes, I am standing right beside you. I am one of two Kunari in this whole building.
I still remember
Here's... I brought you some secrets.
Cambian slippers, trimmed with pearls and emeralds. And those buckles. Toss her into the lake and she'll sink right to the bottom. What a disaster.
Shoes?
There's a Tevinter assassin on the loose, and you're concerned about buckles? On shoes?
Everyone needs a hobby. Besides, you can learn a great deal about a person from their clothing.
Can you?
Gold and jewels on a dancing slipper. A slipper is easily lost and finds itself in the dust and dirt. She is unconcerned with the possibility of losing the shoe or soiling it. A vulgar display of wealth. But Lady Cambian's family has recently lost most of its holdings. They have their title, but...
So where did she get the money for this shoe?
So, how did Cambian acquire such a grand shoe, What has she done? Who has she bedded? These are all useful questions, no?
You make a valid point, Liliana. I do have information for you.
I found this out. I'm not sure of its value.
Very interesting. It may not help our investigation, but we can put it to use. A little more dirt like this, and we might have some leverage in the court. If you find more, let me know.
I will.
I should go. Be on your guard.
I always am.
I'm still looking for Iron Bull. Colin.
Is it true the Inquisitor was headed out of the Fade by Andresti?
No? Oh. Oh, this is just that little balcony.
It's been too long.
You must dance with me, Commander. You cannot stand about all evening.
I'm afraid not. Thank you.
Oh, poor Colin.
My third husband, Pierre, lost his life to Rosalia. I swore.
Okay, well, I guess we'll
forever.
Go to the guest wing door is open now. Let's head that way. I cannot tell you how happy I am to have reasonable load times back. Alright, what's over here? Hall of Heroes. Well, this place is cool. Oh.
There must be something here.
What am I looking for? It looked like the statue. Oh. A coin. Okay. What is this? Commissioned by Empress Selene in honor of the Grey Warden actions at the Battle of Denarim, which ended the Fifth Blight. What, these lions? They don't have wings, so they're not supposed to be griffins. Whispering elf. Be a little more conspicuous,
we're
elf lady.
Not serving drinks. Bother someone else.
Okay. How about I stand over here? I didn't realize they were coming my way.
Interesting.
Oh, eavesdrop in this specific spot, Hera.
The package is in the guest wing. Upper room.
The one of the garden. Statuette.
Okie dokie. What's in here? Oh, hey. Oh, hey, there's an outside. Oh.
Of that before threatening to burn them all in their homes.
That makes sense. Oh. Where is the conspicuous elven servant here? Oh, there isn't one.
Just gossip.
Oh, lame. There's a text here. More Elysian Theater. Oh, but that wasn't what we were looking for. Whoops, another coin. Okay. Oh, what's about to happen here? Nothing. Let's talk to this wandering guy.
Philippe should have returned hours ago, dallying with some serving girl while I deal with Gaspar's vitriol.
Philippe is a jerk.
Awfully selfish of this Philippe.
running off to play and leaving you with all the work.
I've half a mind to inform the Dowager. That would teach him to shirk his duties to roll some elven maid. Tonight of all nights, leaving me to convey Gaspar's death threats to the Council. Wonderful timing, Philippe. Thank you for listening to me, Rant. You are too kind, Inquisitor.
No, you are too kind, Council Herald Messenger Guy. How about this guy? Can I talk to you?
Well, well, the Inquisitor.
That's me.
Here as a guest of my nephew, no less.
Oh, Gaspard's your nephew? Oh, I guess that's a question there, huh?
I didn't know the Grand Duke was your nephew.
He's my brother's eldest boy. Always a difficult child, Gaspard. Never listened, never did what he was told. He was raised a prince. All his life we told him he would be emperor. His destiny, his duty.
And now
what
this.
What else should he do with his life if not fight for his destiny?
I guess it kind of makes sense. Tell me about this whole Civil War thing.
If you are hoping for insight, you've come to the wrong man.
Well, you know more about it than I do.
It is brutal and terrible and sometimes necessary. There's nothing more to say.
Have you seen anything interesting tonight?
Have you noticed anything strange?
Other than the fact that I'm the guest of your nephew?
Hasn't spoken to me all evening. That's not like her.
Good to know.
Another time, my lord.
61! We're getting somewhere. Oh, let's eavesdrop again.
Good to know.
Oh, hey, we found something useful that time. Oh, hey, here's Bull. Oh my god, Bull, you're wearing clothes. Bull, you're wearing clothes.
You got anything that needs killing? Because the nobles keep messing with me and they think I don't know they're doing it. This keeps up. I'm gonna wear somebody's skull as my fancy little mask.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Did you like the masks?
What do you think of the masks the nobles are wearing?
They're no good as disguises, and they don't cover the mouth or hide body language. So they're not much help for lying. As fashion goes, I don't know. I've seen dumber.
Give me a read on this place.
Look at this with the eyes of a Ben Hasroth, and tell me what you see.
It's a mess. Everyone's trying so hard to hide that they're walking around in plumage. Makes it tough to spot the dangerous lies, as opposed to the normal stuff. Oh, but that couple over there with the silver masks. The woman's doing one of the nobles, and the guy's doing two.
Where? Over where? Servants. Other than that,
anything good? Eye?
They've got these candied nuts with some kind of spice on them. It's sweet until you swallow, and then, bam, hot. Also, Orle has some fine-looking redheads. I go more for the servants personally. Less makeup. Nothing on the assassins, though.
All right, then.
Talk to you later, Bull.
I'll just stay here and eat.
Sounds like a plan. That might be the ham that tastes of despair, so enjoy. There's a ham that tastes of despair. Oh, these guys.
You don't want to be here, stranger.
Don't I? There's blood on the floor. It sounds like somewhere I belong.
He hasn't made the pickup. It's been hours.
Uh-oh.
He went into the servants' wing. Nobody's come out of there all night.
I'll tell Briella we have a situation.
Okay.
Interesting.
What's interesting?
Did you hear what Gaspard said to Duke Germain? His own uncle.
Germain bore his nephew's spite better than the rest of the council. Did you see that panicked attaché roaming about?
I did, actually. I thought it was this guy, but it's not. Hi.
This way is closed. Please, use the main entrance to the pool room.
Okay. What's out here? Whatever's binging. That thing. Cylinder seal. What is...
Well, well. What's this?
A cylinder seal. Clara, kitchen staff, entered servants' wing by main stair. 1:30. Vernon, undergardener, entered servants' wing from hall. 2:45. Briala, we need media support down there. Something's gone wrong. because all those people have gone in and not come back out again. I wonder if that's where the blood on the floor came from. Is there a way out? No, that's not what I thought it was. Is this a way out? Oh!
My lady Inquisitor.
Hi.
Then we have a word. It is very important.
The Empress has sent us with a message for you.
And how do I know?
How can I be certain this message is from the Empress?
We three wear the masks of House Valmont.
They signify that we are public faces of the Empress.
They are also extremely fashionable.
Okay. That's nice to hear from her.
I'm always honored to hear from Her Majesty.
Oh, she is the honored one, Inquisitor.
Empress Celine is eager to assist the Herald of Andraste in her holy endeavor.
She will pledge her full support to the Inquisition as soon as the usurper Gaspar is defeated.
I like their outfits, actually. I take it she wants me to
Let
help
me guess.
Her.
All she wants in return is for me to help her defeat the Duke.
Oh, this is not meant as a bargain by any means, Inquisitor.
The support of the Empress is not conditional. It will be yours once the negotiations are concluded. The Empress is the most skilled diplomat in Thedas. Gaspar is hopelessly out of his depth.
Oh.
But we have taken enough of your time.
Please, enjoy the masquerade, Inquisitor.
Why am I not wearing a mask? Hmm. What's happening out here? How do I... Oh, I guess you can almost see the Hollow statue from all the way up there. I almost used Mark of the Rift just there. Anything else happening? What? I can throw coins in here. Well, you might as well do that. Oh, they upped my court approval. Oh, I only have two? I only have two. Read plaque. The Art of the Lady of Regrets. Okay, that's what that statue is called. Oh, yep. I bet she regrets getting down in there.
Maker, I hope not.
Interesting.
Oh, I can eavesdrop on these guys, apparently. Oh, loot!
You must be mistaken.
No, I'm quite certain it was blood on the
tiles. I saw blood on the tiles, too, in
the
guest wing.
You're not doing it very well. You don't leave evidence if you play to win.
With Gaspar and that elf woman here, the only one playing to win is Celine.
Let's get some loot. An amulet of strength. Oh, hey, that was one of the red Jenny stashes. Some velveteen. We're gonna make some new armor when this is all over.
Because you fancy the Empress's pet apostate.
What?
It sickens me to think of the chaos those Maleficarum are causing across the Empire.
Even you cannot deny that the Templars abandon the faithful in their darkest hour. How can you condone that? They are the ones who should be brought to heel, if you ask me.
They technically already have been. I've done so. We need three Hollow statues to open this. Alright. I'm going to be very sparing with my Hollow statues. If you've not played this, there are not enough Hollow statues to open all the Hollow statue doors. So you need to pick and choose which ones you want to open. I want that statue. Let's go. Yes, blood on the tiles. Now we've got to hurry up because this will lower our court approval if we're not careful. If you get too far away from the edge, you're considered out of the party. What's this? Ooh, scandalous testimony. More stuff to deliver to Liliana. I'll seek court approval. That's for the door. Yep. I'm pretty sure this one we have to open, though. Okay, what's in this room? Negotiation documents. Celine, we can discuss this like adults, can't we? We both know the weapon at Briala's disposal could not only turn the tide of war, but every war. The Empire must control it. I do not believe you disagree. She is now a greater threat to Orle than anything else. If you and I work together, we can wrest control away from her. Do not deceive yourself that she'll be open to negotiation or diplomacy. You know her better than anyone. You know that's impossible. What does Briala have that could turn the tide of every war? Ooh, a bow. I don't think that that's what she has. Okay, let's get back to the party before anybody notices we've been gone. Let's check out that bow. It is better than the one. No, it's not as good as the one we've been using. Never mind. We can't equip it because of where we are. See, we're fine. Everything's fine. Can I eavesdrop on these guys again? No. I know. Mecha, I hope not. Whatever these Delancey's are, I bet I would like them a lot. Okay. Explore the Grand Library. Let's do this fast. There's a book. It opened this. There's a letter. Lady M, I need you at my side tonight. The unpleasantness in the royal wing has convinced me there's no safety within the palace. I do not expect my cousin to employ magic, but I would hardly be surprised if he provoked another infestation. Since my court enchanter is not here to assist me. That's my fault, sorry. Veilfire? Oh. Health of magic defense?
We should get back to the ballroom.
Oh no. We should have read those statues. Read those paintings. No? Okay. Is this one first? No. Okay, so this one is first. What about this one? Okay, it's blue. Okay, it's blue. How about this way now? Red. Shit. Court approval dropping. How about this way? Okay. Okay, good, okay, good. Okay. Second bell, fashionably late. Let's go. Our court approval is actually higher than it was when we left. That's a good thing. Get back in there.
Yes, wasting his time. Interesting. Oh.
Let's take 2 seconds to eavesdrop and then we'll go back. Anything good?
Just gossip.
Lame.
Does anyone really think the war will end tonight?
Let's go. Back to the ballroom.
Well.
Oh.
What have we here?
Hello?
The leader of the new Inquisition. Fabled herald of the faith. Delivered from the grasp of the Fade by the hand of blessed Andraste herself.
That's what they say.
What could bring such an exalted creature here to the Imperial Court, I wonder? Do even you know?
Well... it's a mystery.
We may never know. Courtly intrigues and all that.
Such intrigues obscure much, but not all.
I love Morrigan.
I am Morrigan.
So much.
Some call me advisor to Empress Celine on matters of the arcane. You have been very busy this evening, hunting in every dark corner of the palace.
Yeah,
perhaps
well.
You and I hunt the same...
I hope so.
I hope so. I could use another ally here.
I'm so tall.
A sentiment I share, considering recent events.
Recent events?
Recently I found and killed an unwelcome guest within these very halls. An agent of Tevinter. So I offer you this, Inquisitor.
So you found the assassin already.
Found on the Tevinter's body. Where it leads, I cannot say. Yet if Celine is in danger, I cannot leave her side long enough to search. You can.
Is the Empress safe?
You left Celine alone? Is that wise?
I must return to her anon, but she is safe enough for the moment. Would be a great fool who strikes at her in public in front of all her court and the Imperial Guard.
So why are you protecting her again? Like, what are you even doing here?
You're protecting Empress Celine. Are you her bodyguard?
Other than being amazing, I mean.
Do I seem a bodyguard to you? If anything were to happen to Celine, eyes would turn first to her occult advisor, even if they knew otherwise. There are sharks in the water, and I will not fall prey to them. Not now, not ever.
I feel like this is a stupid question. I'm pretty sure I know what door that key
Briala's
opens.
Briala's people are whispering about disappearances in the servants' quarters. This key may lead there.
The ambassador does have eyes and ears everywhere, does she not? Proceed with caution, Inquisitor. Enemies abound, and not all of them aligned with Tevinter. What comes next will be most exciting.
Morrigan is so awesome. Okay, before we go back into the ballroom, I'm going to leave this one here for the moment. Next time, we will continue our investigation at Halam Shiral. Thank you very much for watching. My name is Wench Fairy. This is Dragon Age Inquisition, and we will see you next time.